everyone, welcome to my channel. Today's video is actually a request that I got quite a while ago, quite frankly, from both a friend and subscriber of my channel. A friend of mine and a subscriber of my channel, yeah. Point being, to do sort of a K-pop look, basically like more of an Asian style pop star look. So this is what I came up with after checking it out on Google and just, you know, seeing what, you know, basically would classify as such. This is actually quite a wearable look and also quite a beginner-proof look. Like, you could skip the falsies if that's not your thing. But there's no harsh liner, there's really no harsh lip line either. Like, everything is just very soft and easy, so let's hurry up and get started. Okay, we're gonna start off with the face this time around. I really had to search for a BB cream. Like, I want dewy skin because it seems to be rather a theme with the look. And dewy skin, well, a BB cream works well with that, but I literally have one of which I hope that it's actually going to be pale enough for me. We'll see. Because, yeah, the eye look is going to be very simple because, you know, it's basically just a bit of smoky liner and lashes, so I don't expect any fallout with that. I'm just going to apply this with a brush this time around, just because I feel like with this particular product it just works better. For under the eyes, I'm basically going for my skin color, which is now a little bit darker than my neck. Because obviously the BB cream was too dark. But there doesn't seem to be like the big highlighting thing going on as, you know, we do in more Western makeup, I guess. So I'm just gonna leave it at this and also conceal my nose a little bit more. Now I'm gonna set it with powder. I'm not going to apply too much powder, not as much as I would as usually, but I do want a powder because I have oily skin and I know my skin. If I don't powder, then it's just going to end up really, 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 really greasy within like 10 seconds before the tutorial is even done. So yeah, just playing it safe here. I did that just now with a small brush underneath my eyes and at the T-zone with a loose powder. And I'm just going over the rest of my face with a compact and a bigger brush. Just because I feel like it adds a little bit more coverage and I just need to set my face because otherwise it just becomes disco ball. Now for contour and bronzing, I'm just going to do a very smooth, soft one because they don't seem to be very, like, pictures I saw of K-pop stars, they don't seem to be very, very shaded and all. So I do want to keep it, you know, something that I would wear. But I also want to keep it sort of like the natural way like they look. And they look very natural. So I'm just going to keep it quite basic this time around. Okay, I hope you can see the difference between my eyes. That's what we're going to do. I'm going to start off with a bronzer in the crease. Seriously, it's cloudy outside and now the light keeps changing and it's very, very frustrating. Anyway, yeah. Basically, I use three daylight lamps and the actual window, so that's a bit finicky. But anyway, I'm just applying the contour shade in the crease as well with a tinier brush, obviously. Because there doesn't seem to be a lot of eyeshadow going on the eyes almost. At least not the thing that I usually do. I'm also applying it below my eye, which you could probably already tell from me doing it. But yeah, no bold colors to the eyebrows. No, it's all quite natural and smooth. But yeah. So that's what we're left with at this point. Now I'm going to apply quite a lot of blush, especially on the apples of my cheeks. And this is a shimmery pink peach-ish blush. That was a very clear explanation, but you can see what it looks like. It's a very old one by Catrice. I'll list it below the video. This is anything else I used. But I gotta admit, I'm not sure if they still actually sell this one. Because it's ancient. But nevertheless, I'm just gonna apply it around my face. I'm also going to apply this blush on my eyelid a little bit. Also, I've had it for like 5 to 10 years, I'm not sure. And finally, I hope you can tell, I finally hit pen on it. I feel ridiculously proud of myself for some reason. But anyway, I just want to give my eyes a little bit of color and also some shimmer. So that's why I'm just applying it on my lids. Gonna do my eyebrows. Yes, this one is already done. Very simple. I'm going to use a powder for it. And to really get this perfect, you'll probably need to tweeze your eyebrows. But I don't want to tweeze mine. So I'm just going to go on top of where the actual tail is. And just pretty much just roughly fill them in sort of a more straight shape than I usually would do. Because basically they look very not really filled in, actually. They look very natural and very... as if they don't spend 12 hours tweezing them. Basically. Which probably saves a lot of time. But anyway, so I'm just going to keep them simple as well. That's why I'm using a powder and not a pomade. Because I feel with a pomade I'm just going to end up really drawing them in. And that's just exactly what I don't want today. So yeah, powder just really helps to keep it all kind of soft. Then I'm going to do a very simple sort of kitten wing. So basically I'm just going to fling out my wing, and yes, I have a mirror closer by now so that I actually can see what I'm doing as well. And for this I would recommend using a black eyeshadow or a cake eyeliner, but use it dry. I'm using a dry cake eyeliner. Mostly because my only black eyeshadow is the old Kiko one. Some of you might remember it, and it's still as broken as it was back then. Still a very good eyeshadow, but it broke and I just don't want to risk fallout while I've already done my face. But yeah, I'm just applying this and then sort of making it blend in with my eyelashes here at the top. So the line sort of just disappears in my lashes. And then basically just blend it out a little on the top so it's not too deep and dark and strong. But rather just soft and smoky. And I'm also pulling this to the bottom a little bit, just to make sure that my bottom lashes stand out a little bit more. Connect it to the wing. And why does this eye always turn out darker than the other? It's a rhetorical question. I know the answer is because I accidentally keep making it darker. But still. Anyway, but yeah, the idea basically is I do want the wing shape, the elongated eye shape. But I don't want it to be very dramatic. It's really difficult for me, but I'm managing. I didn't quite feel complete, so I am actually giving myself a little bit of a line out in my inner corners. Not in my contact lenses, preferably. Just so I feel complete. Okay, we're almost done with the eyes. I'm just going to fill in my waterline now with a pale pencil to make them look bigger. And I'm also going to do my lashes with both falsies and some mascara. And also, I've got a fun story for you about my latest stupid thing that I did. So yeah, basically I'll just apply the mascara and meanwhile I'll tell you the story. The story is probably longer than the mascara is going to take, but anyway. It was morning and everything was well in the world and my laptop was doing fine. It had a new, like a couple of months ago I actually bought a new battery for it, which it was a first. I never actually bothered to buy a new battery for a laptop because they were all pretty much doomed by the time their battery started dying. And I was like, just doing my thing, doing my skincare, grabbing coffee, working on my laptop, and that's pretty much where it went wrong. Like, literally, I had slippery hands from the skincare. Then I decided to go grab my coffee, which was behind the laptop, lift it over the laptop, and then halfway through it slipped out of my hands, and it fell on the laptop. So basically, I drank a quarter of the coffee. A quarter of it ended up on my sweatpants, and then half of it ended up in my laptop. Like, literally all over, not even the screen, no, literally all over the keyboard. So I was like panicking, and I was like, I need to fix this, so what do? I don't immediately switch it off. No, I tried to dab it dry, which obviously didn't work, and then the screen flipped out, and I was like, oh, I need to switch it off. And yeah, basically I lifted it up and the coffee just basically came pouring down from it. At which point I was like, okay, I'm just going to let this dry and just see, just out of curiosity, if it will still actually start up even after a couple of hours of drying. But I'm just going to buy, order a new one right now, because this is just not going to end up well. This is just not going to work. This is not going to be a living useful laptop anymore after this point in time, due to my own very fault. So yeah, long story short, I now have a new laptop, all videos from this one onwards, and actually the shopping haul thing from last Saturday as well, are all edited on my new HP Pavilion laptop. Because obviously the laptop just really, like, I tried to still, like, start it up and it just didn't, it's just completely dead, it doesn't do anything anymore. So yeah, I have a new rule in my life now. No coffee can sit on the same desk, or tea for that matter, cola, whatever. No drinks allowed on the same table as my laptop. I'm keeping my coffee like on the desk next to me, on the table behind me. My desk is over there. So that I might maybe toss it on the carpet at some point in time. But the carpet is a black carpet, so that doesn't matter because it doesn't stain easily. But no more coffee on the laptop. And the worst thing is actually, well, basically the worst thing is that the laptop really wasn't even bad yet. Like, it could have lasted for another year, but no, I just had to drown it with coffee. It was also good coffee, and the laptop didn't even appreciate it. Like, it was good coffee. I always drink good coffee. I like coffee. I like having good coffee, and it just was wasted on that laptop as well. So yeah, basically that was my fun story of the week. Anyway, oh, by the way, if you follow me on Instagram, you might have already actually seen that story, because I did actually put it on my Instagram story that same day, because why not amuse others with my stupidity? Anyway, I'm going to apply a pair of natural falsies now, because I want longer lashes on the top. So yeah, and I'm going to remove the old glue of them first. Okay, the lashes are on. I did, as you could tell, probably apply them a little bit more to the inner corner than I usually would, just to have the to have it more doll-like, basically, and less flared out as I usually would apply them. Also, in case you could tell, yes, they're very old, dingy, they're sort of like crooked in weird bits at the lash band, and they have bald spots. And yes, I do actually have spares, about like a pack of like 5 or 6, I don't know how many are in there, and this is the first pair, and I've been telling myself for months that I really need to replace them, and I still haven't actually gotten around to replacing them. Anyway, maybe I should throw coffee on them, and then I'll finally replace them. Point being though, now we're going to move on to the lips. I'm just going to apply a pink liquid lipstick and just sort of dab it out. That seems to be rather a thing, to have like sort of more natural color, not a very strong lip line, but more of a natural color, and then blended it out. That was no proper English. But anyway, to just have that, the, you know, the lip colored yet not really filled in around the edges. And then I'm going to cover that with a lip gloss to make it glossy. Another plus of this technique is that you can't really tell if your lips are symmetrical or not. It's a double win. Still gonna apply a little bit of setting spray and then we're done. And that leaves us with the final results. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this look and had some fun listening to me explaining what not to do with the laptop if you want to keep it intact. And like, seriously, worst part, a few weeks before the laptop, I also had to buy a new phone because the screen of my old phone just started coming off. Like, it just started separating itself from the rest of the phone randomly. Like, I don't know what happened, it just happened. So yeah, apparently I'm just cursed with technology this month. It's a thing in life, apparently. But anyway, so yeah, if you did enjoy this video, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my YouTube channel, as long as not all that other technology also fails on me and my camera dies and my lamps die, and let's just hope that won't happen. Anyway, for now at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!